you're going to have Jesus, whose name is Yeshua. He had the spirit that came from the Father because he obeyed. You got the same spirit and you disobeyed. Somebody hot. If you got the same exact spirit he had, and you can cuss, lie, smoke, cheat, steal, turn and fall, turn it, then Jesus was a liar.
Major terrorism day. The preacher.
Romans 6 and verse 11. I'm sure 12 what I want, but he said 11. I can work that in too. Romans chapter 6 and verse 11. Listen to the book.
Likewise.
Reckon
ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin.
Now, how in the world are you dead? Now, somebody you know to be dead, you pop up and they send them here walking around. They ain't dead.
That's right.
Or either you looking at a hand. Now he said that liking yourself to be dead under sin, that means you no longer, when a person is dead, we know they lie, that means they no longer participate. Matter of fact, on the obituary, they call them delayed. Why? Because they ain't here. You're not here, they call you late. So now he just said the liking yourself, you're supposed to be, resume yourself to be dead to sin, just like you know to be dead to the world. Now he just said, like yourself to be dead. How in the world you dead to sin and you still cuss every now and then? You still smoke and drink and fornicate, commit adultery. You not dead, you still alive. I'm blind like a lot of folks watching me. They been telling you lies. It's amazing though. Oh, you ain't gotta keep Pentecost. You ain't gotta keep unleavened bread. You ain't gotta keep none of that. But how you got Bible for pastor appreciation?
That's right.
How you got Bible for choir appreciation? Yep. How you got Bible for men day, women day? Not even biblical, but God showed you that. But he told you don't obey the book. You got the wrong spirit.
Yep.
But you say that Nat King Cole should be slapped upside his head and the conk knocked out of his head because he sang Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
Yeah.
You said the Grinch that stole
Christmas. I think that was messed up. Go ahead, Boo. Tell
you
about that.
You said the Grinch that stole Christmas
and
is really the hero
and
of the story.
You got to say to people. He stole, when the Grinch came and stole something bad from the people, killed the Grinch. Everybody know Robin Hood.
The Grinch stole Christmas.
Save the people. I told him I can't watch the movie because the end just messes me up.
You said that Bible schools, the seminary, messing people up.
I totally agree with
you. You don't agree with seminary?
I don't.
Why?
Because,
I don't get it.
Well, a lot of times you start dealing with logic, and that kills people. When you look at biblically, and it goes right back. It's amazing how we can take the Bible. We want to raise money, bring all the tithes into the storehouse, rob the Lord. When it comes down to other things he say, we just, you know, casually throw it out of the door. The Sabbath, there's so many different things we throw out of the door when we don't want to do it. And seminary start dealing with logic. What was going on at that time? What were the people doing? What were the culture? Apparently, the people were disobeying the word. The people were just like the people doing now. And people always use it for an excuse when they don't want to obey the Bible.
We only got 30 minutes.
Charlie, roll.
So I got to let it roll. Donnie McClurkin had a song.
Remember it.
You said that he's going to hell.
Yeah, I down to production. I don't believe it. The book of Jude.
Stop. He sang, we fall down, but we get up.
You fall down. I can't speak to it. I don't. The Bible in Jude, I'm going to give you Bible. Jude, the 24th verse. If you read Jude, the last book before Revelation, he said, now to him that's able to keep you from falling and present you faultless. How is it that we're going to sit around and profess the walk and live right, and then we're still committing sin, and then we're still back into the old behavior what we had before grace and truth?
Because people are not really studying biblical theology, chronology, eschatology in depth, they're not digging deep and putting their roots down on the rock, they're being caught up.
The Creator has chosen the seventh day of the week. Regardless of what people claim to worship God, Creator, by observing that day, particular day, they are bringing honor and respect.
Holy question arises at the very beginning of the Bible in the book of Genesis. It speaks almost immediately there about the Sabbath, the seventh day of the week. It is as though God wanted this issue clearly established in the minds of the Bible's readers from the outset of their study of Scripture. Right after the creation chapter, the Bible states this, thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day, God ended his work which he had made, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work which he had made. And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, which means to set apart for holy use.